Our farm is called One Acre Unlimited, and on that farm we keep pigs, we keep cattle, we keep fish, we grow matoke and different types of vegetables. Our cash cow is pigs. We make about $60,000 a year from the pigs. And then the other 40,000 we get it from the cattle, fish, poultry, and vegetables. Each project, because we also run a school, so each project is also run or looked after by different learners at the school. So they also keep records in their classes. Records are very important. Even it tells you how will you know that you make profits if you don't keep records. Take for example, how much food are you giving? How much did you buy the food? But we also use the computers. We also have different apps on our phones because 3/4 of the time we have our phones. So with the piggery, we use the Pig Champ. With cattle, we use the Dairy Co. So these are apps that we use for making sure that we have records, that at even when we are away from the farm, we actually look at our records. We stay here actually on the farm. So if anything happens, even at night or early in the morning, we are here and ready to attend to the animals. Now, it's very, very important. Hygiene is a very important aspect. So many people, we keep pigs and people think pigs are dirty, but they're actually not. So we make sure they are clean by picking the dung, and this dung actually helps us to feed the animals. With our most recent innovation, we are making something that is going to help us remove the hairs off the pigs, because normally when you slaughter the pigs, there's a hard job of actually removing the hair. You have to use a razor, it takes some time. We have an innovation to just remove. It's a very interesting, we know that we are done and it works, we shall sell it out. Another innovation is that we are now making foliar manure or base manure from humus and blood from the pigs. Many years ago we came to this village, and in 2010 when we came there was a lot of theft. So it's a fishing village, and whenever government said don't fish, people were idle. And because they were idle, they started stealing. The only food that was on this village was cassava, sweet potatoes and posho. So when we started farming and grew matoke, I remember the first time people laughed at us. They're like, matoke doesn't come back to this place. And now all the neighbors on the village grow matoke, all the neighbors, even those who used to do fishing. I impacted the village. People now have learned how to farm. And not only the village, but we've impacted the whole, I would say the whole country. When people started coming and asking us to run to their farms, we're like, no, we can't come to your farm, and yet we have ours. So we decided to build a school. This school is called MST Junior School, and it does the three things every African should know: time management, value of money, and the culture of saving through farming. So we train the learners in MST Junior School to farm, and these learners go back to their homes. They act as mini extension farmers or extension officers. They teach their parents what to farm. They teach the neighbors who can't afford to come here. They also teach them. So that way we've actually impacted the whole nation, and we are really, really proud of that.